So you may know what a domain name is, and you may have heard of Google Domains. Google Domains is a place where you can go to and you can register your new domain name. And if you've got a Google My Business, or you've got a particular website that's been using perhaps Shopify, WordPress, you'll know that the free domain names aren't really that helpful when it comes to your business cards and helping others find your website. So what actually is a domain name? Well, a domain name is, you've probably heard of a .com, a .co.uk, a .info, a .net. Those domain names, in effect, are a name that's been registered and that you have like an ownership, or you rent it out, and then you can make people that type that into a browser, they can then go directly to your website. And that looks more professional. So for example, if you wanted to visit McDonald's and you wanted to go to their website, you'd expect them to have mcdonalds.com and you'd find it there. So rather than searching for McDonald's in a search engine like Google or Bing, you can just directly type it into a website or into a browser, and that website will come up because you know the domain name. And if you spoke to the managing director, you'd expect him to perhaps be CEO at, and then it'd be the domain name, mcdonalds.com, for example. So LaRue Window Cleaning Services.business.site was the shortened version of what we did a few lessons ago, where it was LaRue Window Cleaning Services, window cleaning services.business.site. Why was it so long? Well, what Google by default will do with your Google My Business is it will take the name of your business, it will add it to the first category, the primary category you've chosen, and then it will then add to it .business.site. And that's a free website that everyone's given when they use Google My Business. Now, we've shortened it down already, but it's still far too long. My client says, look, it's worth paying to get the domain name that I want. So we're going to purchase a domain name today through Google Domains. I'm going to show you how to do it. I'm also going to tie it up with the Google My Business website. And within a few minutes, we'll hopefully have a new website that my client then can bring customers to. So let's see how we get on. So the owner of LaRue Window Cleaning Services is pleased with the progress that's being made, and he's getting inquiries, getting calls, and we're keeping things nice and up to date, as you'll have seen on the previous video. So we're now into episode 12, and this is a bit more about, we've seen the website's been built, but he now wants to advertise his website. He wants people to be able to go to his website. So how do you get people to go to the website? How do you get your domain name to get out there, to be seen, perhaps put on business cards, put on your vans? How do you connect it to a proper professional domain name? Well, Google My Business, it does provide you with a few options. First of all, if you just notice on the homepage, it does say now you're on the web. Now let's just dissect what this is here. So customers can find you. That's your domain. So if I click on that, it opens up the website, and then they can book appointments, they can call, and you've got the about page, you've got testimonials. I mean, it's all beginning to come together. So you've got a website here with gallery and so on. So there's plenty on here as a website, but of course it is a free website. It's powered by Google. So it's not the most professional website, but it certainly is one that will just get a bit more traffic. Maybe you want customers to go there to see some pictures, to see you've got branding and so on. But how do you get someone to go there? How do you get this URL? Well, if you notice, if we go back to here, you'll notice that this is his website, HTTPE, instead of the www dot, you just go straight into larue-window-cleaning-service.business.site. And that's very long-winded, and it's not one that you're going to be able to remember. You might get the dot or the dash in the wrong place. The way this is built up is, in fact, that it was a lot longer than this originally, where they put together the business name and the primary category, and then it's added to .business.site. Now you can make some changes here. So if we go into it, you'll notice you can make a change to this. So you could just put larue.business.site, but it still looks like a free website if you end with this .business.site. And then Google's really found a way around that, because you can combine your free website with Google domains. So if you go to domains.google and you've got this beta, Google Domains it's called, and you can read a bit more about it if you don't know much about what domain names are. But basically you can now buy your domain names through Google, which means that you can get these things working nicely together. Now, there's a few ways to do this. The easiest way, if you're just wanting to combine it with your Google My Business, is just to go back to your Google My Business, and up here you'll see you can buy the domain, and that's what we're going to do. And it gives you a few options. So you might want the co.uk, or you might want the .com. You might be asking what's the difference, and .net and .org. Well, what this is doing is, first of all, it's taking the business name, and which is ideal for having as a domain name. If you wanted to do just LaRue, being four letters, that wouldn't work. That's too small these days. You need at least, I think, five or six now to purchase a domain, because the fours and threes and probably most of the fives have been taken. And a .com is if you're going to go kind of more global and expand. If you're just wanting it to be Britain or whatever the country is that you're from, then you can go for a more local domain. So co.uk would work fine, but in this case I'm going to go for the .com as it's available and it's all the same price, and I'm going to purchase that in a moment. But you could do it the other way around. You might just want to search for a few things. I mean, in this case I'm going to search for LaRue, and you could try something a bit different, but if you just wanted to say LaRue Windows. The trouble with that is it could be that you're fitting windows. It doesn't actually make you a window cleaner. That'll do a search to see what's available. And then you'll see that quite a few are available. So you're looking for which ones are free. So that's LaRue in Windows. You don't want that. But LaRueWindows.uk is available. But there's it does say here .com, .net and all the other endings as well. So you might want to just pick the one that you particularly want. But anyway, in this case, LaRue Window Cleaning. And there you go. So the .com is available, co.uk is available, and so on. So I'm going to go for the .com. I'm just, to get it to tie up nicely, I'm going to make sure, because I know then it will definitely be spelt the correct way. All through here, I'm going to click buy. So grow your business online, buy LaRueWindowCleaning.com, get the perfect domain. So this is going to be so much easier to get customers to go to this, and it's £10 a year. Or you can buy LaRue Window Cleaning with a G Suite as well. So the price is starting at £10 a year. So it says it's exact match, which is exactly what you want to see. Has the advantage of being a .com. Disadvantage is it's considered a little bit long. Having said that, you've got window cleaning in your domain name, which can't be a bad thing. So let's click buy. And you can choose to have it over several years if you wanted to, so you haven't got to keep renewing it. We'll go for the 1 year for now. You've got privacy protection on. You can have auto renew so that you don't have to worry about remembering to renew it. And you can add workspace to it and so on if you wanted to. And of course you can add things like having a custom email if you wanted. So once it's paid, then it's being registered. It's being registered, there you go. You'll get confirmation email come through and you can go back to Google My Business. It can be taking up to 20 seconds to redirect. So yeah, you're on the web. Congrats, your business is now online. It can be found by customers at LaRueWindowCleaning.com. View site, let's click there. So at the moment it's gone back to the old site, but let's just see whether or not that's available. So that's a case of, that's now going to be the client's new domain name, and we can take it from there. If I go into my Google Domains now, and there you go. So now it's set up and you can now see that it's connected to Google My Business website and it will get managed on a regular basis. And it's probably needs a verification code. So I'll check my emails and take a look on that.
And there you go. I just refreshed it, therearwindowcleaning.com. Click on here, testimonials. And again, you've got the hash testimonials. And here's just a little trick. So if you wanted to send someone to the summary, you can just send them that link and that hash summary takes them to there.
Now, there are lots of other things you could do to tweak the setup of that domain, to add your hosting of emails to it, to make sure that it redirects on various things as well. And normally my suggestion would be just to wait about 48 hours to let everything propagate through on a domain so that the servers are picked up by all the search engines. So you may find if you rush into it too quickly, some of the features won't work straight away. So that's my top tip there when it comes to registering domain names. Now you may also want to put them all under one umbrella. So Google Domains makes it easy to transfer other domains in if you wanted to do that. You can also, if you've got a domain name with Google My Business, you can also add other features to it, which we'll look at on a future video. But for now, having Google Domains and connecting it to Google My Business is pretty straightforward if you do it the way we did it today. So hopefully you'll give that a go and find a domain name that's catchy, easy to use, and represents your business. When it comes to LaRue window cleaning services, there are a few more things we're now going to do to get people to find it and to get it to stand out from all the other window cleaning businesses. And one of the things that most people don't do is produce packages or products. So I'm going to show you on the next video how you can add products and packages, whatever your business is, there's a way to do it. I'm going to show you how to do that on the next video. So if you want to find out how to do that for your business, then meet me over on this video now. But if you want to just see how do we get to this point with LaRue Window Cleaning Services, then join me here at episode 1 and you'll see how we got to this point in the video.